Okay, so first I went in with a little bit of raw sienna and burnt orange from the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. And when I'm mixing those two colors, as you can see when I'm blending them, I'm putting them right above my crease area. This is just going to act as a transition color before I put on a little bit of the pink color that you will see here soon. So next I went into that same palette using the color Love Letter, and I'm applying this directly into my crease. I'm just using a traditional blending brush. Any blending brush will work. But I am noticing that with this palette, I had to continue to add more shadow to really build the color. And when you see me blending, I'm making sure I'm still going in that windshield wiper motion. I have no clue what I was watching on TV, but I think it was pretty good. So throughout the video, you're probably gonna see me continue to glance over at the television. Now, to add a little bit of depth to that outer V, I decided to use my Masquerade palette from Juvia's Place. And the color I'm using is called Makita. It's like that really true dark purple. Same thing with this palette. It took a lot for me to get the color payoff. I did not change my brush. Yeah, it was the exact same brush. But the only thing with this eyeshadow that you can clearly see is that I had a lot of fallout utilizing this shadow, but it's still one of my favorite brands to use. I love the eyeshadows, love the palettes, but it does take a little work to get the color payoff that you need, and you will experience some fallout. Or maybe I was just being messy, but on this particular look, I had a lot of fallout from these shadows. Now, if you know me, you know I'm always mixing, and this time was no different. Right here, I am applying a little bit of MAC Loose Pigment in the color Heritage Rogue directly on top of that purple from the Masquerade palette by Juvia's Place. I love pigments. I can use a pigment for absolutely everything. I've used it for eyeliner. I've used it for eyeshadow, clearly. I've used it for lipstick, blush. The sky is the limit when you are utilizing any form of a loose pigment. Next, I went in with a flat shader brush, and I'm using Whisper Pink. It's another loose pigment that came from that same holiday set that Heritage Road came from. And all I did was wet my brush a little bit with Fix Plus spray, and I just packed the color on until I was satisfied. So now that we're done with all that extra blending, I was watching TV apparently, but I went in a little bit with MAC Carbon eyeshadow, and I just applied that to my outer V to create a little bit of depth with my eyes, just to be extra, as usual. Okay, so I did my liner and my lashes off camera and went straight into my foundation. Now, on this particular video, I was using Sephora's 10 Hour Wear Perfection Foundation in the color Fonce Deep. It is in the number 57. I am going to have to post an updated foundation routine because I'm darker now. I've been to Cabo. I've changed my foundation color, but I was using Sephora's 10-hour perfecting foundation in this video. But an updated video will be on the way. On to highlighting the face. I'm using the Kat Von D Lock It Concealer in the color D35 Neutral. Same thing with this concealer. I've changed my concealer since then. So when I post my updated foundation routine, obviously it will include my highlight and contour routine, which includes my updated concealer. Because all of that has changed since I filmed this video. Now that we have blended out all of that concealer, I went in with my medium deep loose powder from Laura Mercier. Y'all, this powder is truly amazing, and I have no plans on switching to a different powder anytime soon. But when I do set, I set my concealer as soon as possible after I get done blending it out, because due to my cheeks, I do have large cheeks, my under eyes crease really easily and really quickly, so I try to go ahead and set my concealer as fast as possible. For my contour, I just kept it really simple. I went in with your everyday blush brush, powder brush, whatever you want to call it. And I used the color Espresso from the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit. I only use powder when I contour. I don't like creams. I feel like it's an extra step that's very unnecessary. But anytime I do a contour, I do love to use this powder. So now, just to add a little bit of color back into my cheeks, I went in with a little bit of MAC's Sweet as Cocoa blush. And it is very brown girl friendly and one of my favorite blushes. So to prep my eyes to add a little color to my waterline, I first put a little bit of black eyeliner on. I believe this is Maybelline, but any black liner honestly will work. You just want to start from the corners. So in this moment, I was so frustrated because I messed up and my black liner went a little bit lower than I normally do it. So my eyes had to be super dramatic with this black. I was not happy. So then I went into my Masquerade palette from Juvia's Place and started to pack a little bit of that blue. I believe the color name is Dahlia, and it's in like the top right hand corner of the palette. There I go again looking at the TV. But same thing with this palette, like I said before, you kind of really have to work it to get the color payoff that you need. But I had all these cool pink tones going on the lid, so I want to come back and hit it with a little bit of some blue. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the finished product. I know it took me forever to come back with the video, and I sincerely apologize. But hopefully now I can definitely be on it and be a little bit more consistent and bring you guys more videos, because this was so much fun. And I've grown so much as an artist, and I can't wait for you guys to see. Bye!